I've spent a lot of time recently building with AI coding tools like Replit Agent. And a lot of you might be thinking, should I still invest time into learning no-code tools like Bubble if AI is able to build my app for me? In this video, I'm going to compare and contrast building with no-code, building with AI, talk about where they are different, where they are the same, and whether AI is going to kill no-code tools. If you're new to this channel, be sure to subscribe to get access to all of our future no-code and AI content right here for free. And check the link in our description to go to No-Code MBA, where we have lots of in-depth courses teaching how to build with AI and no-code. The first thing I'm going to talk about is AI tools like Replit Agent, and talk about where it is really, really helpful and where I think right now it falls short. When it comes to building basic prototypes, Replit Agent is really, really good. If you want to build a very basic app that allows you to take an input, for example, put it through OpenAI and get an output, and you don't want to worry about setting up any of the database, you're completely non-technical, Replit Agent is able to do that. Where it starts to fall short, however, is when you are building something more complicated, you're starting to add in more features, the code base that it's writing is starting to get more complicated. I found in my experience that leads to a lot of debugging that you're going to be doing with Replit Agent, and it's going to be really frustrating because you're going to tell the agent that something isn't working and it's not going to be able to fix it, or it's going to try and then it's just going to have the same problem over and over again. When you get to really complex code bases and you don't know how to code, you're not able to go into the code and actually see what's happening on your own. So where these AI coding tools I think are really helpful right now is for building those basic prototypes, or if you already know how to code, using it as your assistant to help you code more quickly. But getting to the point where you're going to build a really complex, fully functional app just from Replit Agent or an AI coding tool, I think is going to be more challenging. With No-Code MBA, for example, we have courses where we cover how to use ChatGPT and Replit to build apps like a Slack bot or a Chrome extension. But in those courses, you learn the fundamentals of how to build a Slack bot, how to build a Chrome extension, looking through the documentation, chatting back and forth with ChatGPT to actually build it, as opposed to Replit Agent, which is more like pressing a button and then getting that result. So that's the difference there when you're using AI coding, and where I think it's useful and where I think it is still challenging. Now, it's very possible that in 6 months after this video is released, AI is going to continue to improve, these tools are going to continue to improve, and maybe this will no longer be a downside to using tools like Replit Agent. Now, let's switch over to talking about tools like Bubble. So Bubble is a web app builder. They're coming out soon with a native app builder as well. Flutterflow is another tool similarly that allows you to build native or web apps using no code and more of drag and drop interfaces. Now, where I think these tools are really powerful is when you do need to build those more complex apps. So if you want to build something super simple, then I think using a tool like Replit Agent could work really well. But if you need to build a more complex app, any type of SaaS app that's going to have a lot of features and users and logic, at that point, that's where I think no-code tools are still really powerful. I still see them being really, really powerful and useful for the foreseeable future, because you need to understand how your app's database is set up, how everything works together, how all the logic is set up. You need to be able to debug it yourself. So if there's a bug, being able to identify that bug, see what's happening, and fix it. And you really need to know how to use a no-code tool like Bubble or Flutterflow in order to do that. So when it comes to building more complex apps, that's where I think these no-code tools like Bubble are not going to be going away anytime soon. Now, I think that there's a hybrid approach that's going to be happening in the future, and something that I'm already using is, for example, let's say I'm building a Bubble app and there's some sort of functionality that I want to happen in my app that isn't natively supported by Bubble. At that point, what I can do is ask Claude or ChatGPT to write some JavaScript for me to actually make that action happen that I want on the page. And then I'm able to use AI to write code to use inside my no-code projects. And this has been really helpful for me in a variety of use cases when I've been building apps. You also could use AI to help you write plugins for Bubble or write code for your Flutter Flow app or whatever you need to do to add code into it. The next way that AI is going to be affecting these types of no-code tools is using AI to actually build inside of the tool. And this is something the platforms themselves are building out. For example, Bubble currently has an AI building feature where you describe what you want and then it'll build it inside of Bubble using AI and based on what you told it. Now, this feature is still pretty basic, and I personally still think it's easier to not use that feature in Bubble, but it's definitely possible that there could be a future where there's maybe a hybrid between Replit Agent and Bubble, where you are working in the Bubble platform, you are able to tell Bubble what you want it to build, similar to Replit, and then it builds it. And then when it comes to debugging, if you understand how Bubble works, then you're able to go in and actually fix it and kind of build more complex things. So the Replit agent or inside of Bubble could help you kind of get that first prototype built literally in a minute, and then you could go on and build, you know, everything else you want on top of it. So that could save a lot of time. And I think that is most likely what the future is going to be for no code and AI, at least in the foreseeable future, because you need to understand how your app works at the end of the day. And if you don't know how to code, it's going to be very difficult to build really complex, very complex apps only using AI and coding. So I think that you can build pretty cool apps using it, but when it starts to be more complex, like imagine an entire app like Airbnb where there's so many things that go into it, that's where I think it's going to be a little bit harder, at least for the foreseeable future. So that's what I'm predicting, that's what I see, but this space is changing just about every day, and AI models are improving all of the time. No-code platforms are improving all of the time. So be sure to stay subscribed to our channel to stay up to date on all of the newest tools that are going to be launched and what the best way to build with no-code and AI is. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Thanks, everyone, for getting us to 10,000 subscribers here on YouTube, and I'll see you in the next video.